name is John C.
Hello, hello, Rosanna.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great.
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. What about you?
Good, it's nice to see you again. It was a long time since we last talked.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Mm-hmm. How have you been?
I've been great. I'm still studying English here on Cambly. And still working and doing my regular activity. Yeah, life is good. Oh, you have a different
crowd. Yeah, I'm at a friend's house. She has a business that's nail related, and this is all the glitter for the product.
Oh, okay, so, all right.
This is why I'm not home right now.
All right. But
yeah, I was working earlier. Before Cambly, I was working, and then I started a few hours ago.
Are you still living? Okay, let me remember. Puerto Rico? No. In America, right?
Yes. In the U.S.
In the U.S. Mm-hmm. And the city was nice. Oh my gosh, what a bad memory I have. I don't remember. Sorry. Can you refresh my mind?
Yeah. I live in Pennsylvania.
Oh, Pennsylvania. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. And in Brazil, in... Hold on. Let me see.
Don't look at my old class. Try to remember.
I don't remember where in Brazil. It's not in Rio, right?
No, not in Rio. Rio. It's
no. It's São Paulo.
Way off the mark.
Oh, I'm not close. Not even close.
I'm gonna give you one more hint, and you can try it. I live in the north. East part of Brazil. Which city?
Is Salvador there? No.
Yeah. I was born.
Yay!
I was born in Salvador, but I am actually living in a city called Natal.
Oh, okay, Natal.
Which means Christmas.
Natal means Christmas. Oh, okay. Awesome. And how have you been lately?
We have all this Christmas spirit inside us.
Oh, there's a Christmas spirit year round?
No, I'm kidding. I wish.
Okay. That would be cool.
So, more kind, more friendly, but no.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a daydream.
Mm-hmm. No. And how has it been now with can you hear me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There was a little bit of delay, but I can hear you okay.
Oh. Okay, cool. How has it been right now in Natal?
You mean related to coronavirus?
Yeah, like how's life right now there?
Natal is not the worst city in Brazil. No, there are other really bad places. But we are still worried about the virus. However, we don't have too many hospitalizations. I think until people get the majority of population, get the vaccine.
Gets the vaccine,
There will always be this concern, this fear of the virus. But we can get.
Mm-hmm, there will always be this fear.
We can get by. We have.
Yeah, exactly.
So
We have to.
I have this game to play with you today. It is called What is
Okay.
Game? It's a little bit interesting. What
What
is
it?
Game? Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
So
Okay.
the game is What If? So I'm gonna ask you a couple of questions and you have to give me your answer. Okay.
Okay.
If you had only 24 hours to live, what would you do?
24 hours to live.
Yeah, to live. Like
Okay.
that,
Okay.
it's your 24 hours. You have to do anything that you want.
Yeah, anything. Okay. Well, I would travel to Puerto Rico to hug my mom, my brother. Of course, let my sister know that I only have 24 hours to live so we can all go home or try to see her. I would let my family know, or at least just kiss them. Maybe I wouldn't let them know, but just be with them. Maybe I would enjoy my last 24 hours at home, really visiting my family and at the beach where my heart is. So yeah,
Yeah.
that's what I could think of right now.
That's cool.
What about
I
you?
would probably do the same, but I would throw a party, you know, that I would invite my friends and his family. I know it's a little bit contradict, right? Because that
Contradictory.
contradictory because it's my last 24 hours. But I would love to spend my time, you know, with this great enjoyment, like to show people that, you know, I was this happy guy that my legacy, I was giving the world this positive legacy.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I like that.
So,
Awesome.
okay, if you were given the opportunity to be born again, how would you change how you lived?
How would I change how I lived?
Yeah.
I would probably stay in one place instead of moving around so much, and choose that happy place to be in, and having that base from there, traveling to the places that I still went to. Like, I don't regret anything that I've done so far, but yeah, if I had to start all over, maybe stability would be something I would focus on if I had to. What about you?
Cool, that's cool. Well, I think I would try, you know, to change a little bit of things that I did. Like to not I'm you know it's not that I regret, you know, because I did what I had to do, you know, because I feel like when I ponder over the things and I choose the best option that I judged in that moment. But now, you know, with my mentality, with my, you know,
Capacity.
the capacity of think better, I would change those things and I would try to do different. But yeah, basically is that thing.
Yeah. Good.
That's a good question, right?
Yeah, I like those questions. I like to feel that stimulation
Yeah.
of interesting conversations.
Okay, now I'm gonna give you a really, really mind-blowing question. If you could ask God any one question, what would it be?
Why is there so much suffering in the world? I would ask him that, honestly. What
Yeah.
about you?
Yeah. Why let innocent people die? Like children, you know? Yeah. Something like
Oh, and if aliens really exist.
that. All right. Speaking of aliens, which planet would you which planet would you like to live? If you know, could it be possible to live?
Well, if we're talking about the planets that we already know, because those aren't places I would like to live in. There's nothing there. Or are we talking in a fictional world where we could live in an amazing?
Yeah, but let's pretend that those planets that we are aware of, they could be.
Okay. Like there's vegetation, yeah, life, water, everything, water. I would be very cliche and say Venus, but not for a particular reason. The moon is not a planet, but I would live on the moon. Does that count?
All right.
Because it's very bright, and I like the how it changes colors.
Yeah.
Okay,
I would like to live close to the sun, right? Because I love going to the city.
You like the warm. Yes.
Yeah. Tan, you know.
Well, you could live in Puerto Rico then. That's very close to the sun. It's hot there all year.
Oh, my city, my city Natal, it's really close.
Hot?
Yeah, hot and... Mm-hmm. Close to the sun.
And close to the sun. It feels close to the sun. Yeah.
Okay. One more question because I think we are running out of time. Okay. If we could live like for 300 years, what would the life be like?
Oh, I got lost. Okay. If we could live for 300 years. What would life be like?
Yeah.
Okay, if I had the ability to live for 300 years?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think it would be good because I would always have a chance to start over. I'll have a lot of time to make a lot of mistakes and not worry about them so much.
Yeah, I like that one.
What about you, if we have time to answer that?
I think it would be like, I hate being repetitive and like, mm-hmm. you know, fail and try to succeed and fail and try mm-hmm. to be the guy and mm-hmm. being boring.
Mm-hmm. Bored. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you know, I think, I don't know. I don't know about that. Anyways,
okay.
What else?
We only have a minute left, by the way.
Oh my gosh, I have to be quickly. If you could travel back in time, where would you go?
I don't know. Maybe I would go to the 70s. To see all this new love and peace movement like happen.
Yes. Yeah, me too.
And be funky and groovy.
And rock and roll.
And rock and roll.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah, I would say the same thing. You know, try to leave this, you know, this moment. Elvis Presley. Mm-hmm. Oh, and
right. So, oh, yeah. That's like what, the 50s maybe, when he was
50s, yeah, sure. 50s, mm-hmm. 70s. I don't know, mm-hmm. but I,
well, yeah. Before Cambly kicks us out, thank you. I love those questions.
Okay,
I hope to see that video. You.